Hi, welcome back to Daily Dose of Rust Language. In this video, you will learn how to write a very simple calculator program with the Rust programming language. This is a very good project for beginners who want to see how the Rust programming language works in general. You also see how to write a very simple unit test to test your code as well. So let's get started. First, generate a project using cargo new. That will create a binary project like this one. You will see your main.rs file. Leave it empty. Then create a new library create by using cargo new. Call it calculator and that will create this folder for you. Inside this folder, you will see the src folder with this lib.rs file. And then inside here, we can create our calculator. Now to get started, all we have to do is to create this calculator struct right here with just one field called results of type F64. This is where you're going to store all the values that we are calculating. Okay, and then we do implement some methods and associated function for this struct. Now, since this field is private, we won't be able to construct this calculator struct. We have to use a new associated function right here. We called it new, and it will return an instance of this calculator for us. You'll see when we use it later on. Now, we have just two methods for adding values and subtracting values. So here, you know that it's a method because it has a self as the first parameter for each method. And it's mutable. Why we are making it mutable is so that we can return it back and be able to change these methods later on. So the second parameters are vectors that we are accepting. So if you want to add some values, you see how you use it in a minute. You add all the values inside the vector, and then for each of those values in those vector, we add them to what we already have in results. The same thing for subtraction. We subtract while we are looping. So minus equal to, we minus the value and then assign it to the results. And then later on, we have a getter method and a setter method to return the results for us. Now, in order to use this, I will show you how the unit tests work soon. In order to use that, all we have to do is to move back to our binary crate in the main.rs file and then get an instance of that calculator using this new associated function. Always remember to first of all, go into the cargo.toml file. Okay, and then add that calculator library create that we've just created and provide the path. Okay, look in the description, you'll see a blog post here explain how you can add these dependencies. There are many ways to add dependencies. And once you've done that, you can then import the calculator struct from that crate right here and then be able to use it. Now, in order to use it, all we have to do is to get a mutable reference of this calculator by using the new associated function. We want it to be mutable so that we can modify it by calling these methods on it. And then call add to add some values. Now we are adding 4.0, 10.0, 20.0, and that will be 34 later on. And then we are subtracting values. And then inside there we have just 100. So it's going to add these numbers and then it's going to minus 100 from them. And then we'll print the result to the terminal. Now if we run that code, you get result is minus 66, and that is correct. 34 minus 100 is minus 66. And then look at the test that we have here. Now in Rust, you write unit test in the same file you write your code. So since we have our code right here in this lib.rs file, we will write our test function here. I'm only writing a test for the addition function to test that it works. So first of all, create a module with this configuration attribute and then give it a configuration option of test, and then inside there you import your calculator. Okay, since you are inside the new module, you have to bring in this calculator inside here, and then you start creating your methods. The first method here is test addition, that test that this method, that test that the addition works. All we have to do is get a mutable reference and add a few values. After setting this one to 4, then we add 5 and 5, and then we are certain that the result is 14, because 5 plus 5 plus the existing 4 should be 14. In order to run this test, however, there are 3 ways to run it. Since it's inside the library, if you just run cargo test, it's not going to run this test. Okay, since you're in the root folder, you have to either move this inside the workspace, the cargo workspace, and then run the test with the workspace flag, or you navigate inside the calculator directory and then run cargo test right there. Or you can use the package flag. For example, you can run cargo test. If you do that, we'll get a few tests. These are integration tests that we have. But right here, no unit test was run because it was not able to find any unit test. So if we want to indicate that we want to run this, you can use the package flag, which we can, if you run cargo test help, you get a few description on how to use this. And you can see the workspace flag that you can use, or this package flag that we can use. The short form is -p, so we can just say cargo test -p, and then we'll give it the name of our library create, which will be calculator. And then when we run that, it's going to run that test, and it will say one test passed, and the test that was run is test, the test module, and then test addition, which is exactly what we have inside the libs.rs file right here, test addition. Okay, so now a few takeaway here. First, a Rust package, we usually have one binary create and many library creates. The binary create is usually an entry point. It usually doesn't have much code. You are just consuming what you have in other crates. If you want to build something unique, like we are building a calculator here, we have to do that inside a separate crate, like a library crate that we've just created here. It will have its own cargo.toml file right here, and then an src folder with lib.rs file. Then secondly, after adding the library create, you won't be able to use it right away. You must go to the binary creates cargo.toml file and then specify that you want to use it as a dependency and provide the type, since it's local to our project. And then inside main.rs, you can then use that library create. Then thirdly, all your unit tests will be written inside the same file you wrote your code. Okay, to keep it organized, move them inside a module called test. When you run cargo test, cargo will only run this test module and then the test functions that are inside here. Every other function that you might have inside this module will not be run as a test, okay, unless they have this test attribute. Now for integration tests, it's a little bit different. You have to create this test folder in the root of your project, and then inside here you can now start defining your integration tests. Now each file you create inside this test folder will be treated as a separate crate. Rust actually see integration tests as external to your project, so they'll just be using your code like an external body. And if you have some configuration files here, like we have this command.rs with a setup file, we don't want it to be run as a test. So all we have to do is to move it into a folder where we have mod.rs. Once this file is inside this folder, Rust is not going to see it as a test, and therefore we will not treat it as an integration test. One thing you will notice with integration tests is that whenever you run cargo test, each file will be displayed as a new section. You can see that we have calculator test, integration test, and it has its own section here. And that's it, guys. Very, very simple. If you have more questions about the Rust programming language in general, leave it in the comment section and I will get back to you. Make sure to like the video and subscribe so you get notified when we make more videos. We make videos for the Rust programming language every single day, so subscribe so that you get notified.